Well, of course, Kylie played at the corner spot most of the time last year, and Wells played the post. I'm not sure just how we'll arrange it this year. We lost the only starter on our squad last year, Ron Perry, and chances are Wayne Mallard will get an opportunity to fill in this one spot that from our starting five that was vacated last year.
Now, of course, he played a lot last year.
Wayne played a great deal. Came in and gave us a lift in several games, and we're looking forward to Wayne stepping right in our starting lineup. As a matter of fact, Wayne started a few games for us last year.
And Glenn Combs, of course, he was outstanding last year.
Of course, Combs, yes, back. Our two guard starters are back, and Combs and Ellis, and of course, Glenn led our scoring last year, and we're looking forward to Glenn having a fine year this year.
I believe a year's experience for Chris Ellis will mean a lot for him as well.
The experience is going to help Chris a great deal. He seems to be shooting better at this stage than he was last year, and his confidence, as you say, with the year of experience and the confidence that he gained will be a great asset to him.
Let's talk a little bit about that schedule right now, Holly. You start off and you hit a buzzsaw immediately.
Yes, it is a very attractive schedule and a good one. It may be, I'm not sure whether it might be a little bit tough for us. You usually like to start off rather light and then get into a tough part of your schedule later, but this is not the case with us, as is the case with a lot of independent teams. We open with Duke on December 1st and play University of North Carolina on the next night and at Chapel Hill on the 2nd, and then we fly to Alabama and play University of Alabama on the 4th. They have a new Coliseum, 15,000 capacity. We'll open this new facility for them. Then we return home and play Wake Forest on the 6th.